Hi, this is Catherine from AHA. Today I'm going to walk you through how to create an ideas portal so that you can gather product feedback in one place. We'll focus on how to set up your portal with the right access, tailoring it to match your company brand, and making sure that you capture the right information about each request. So let's get started. Here we are on the Ideas Overview page in my AHA Roadmaps account. I'm going to click Add Ideas Portal and show you how to create a new one in seconds. You want to give your portal a title. That way your audience knows what portal they're in. And then select a color that matches your brand. You can always come back in here and change these details later on. Now let's select the right access for your portal. Private portals are perfect for limiting access to a specific set of users, while public portals will be open to everybody. I'm going to create a private portal for internal teams to submit requests. And there we go. We've created a new portal in less than 60 seconds. There's a lot that you can do to customize the look and feel of your portal. So let's open up our portal settings and take a look at some of the options. The Overview tab is where you can update your title and choose your subdomain. Let's make our subdomain a bit more simple. If you want to create one portal that serves multiple workspaces, then you can add those workspaces here. This is ideal for capturing feedback across multiple products all in one place. Then, over on the Branding tab, you can update the portal color and add your brand's logo and upload a favicon. Of course, you want to make sure that you capture the right information from your portal users when they submit feedback in your portal and keep all of your requests organized. So let's take a look at how you can do this in the Layout tab. To customize your idea submission form, we can click Create Custom Layout. If you already have a layout, you'll see an option to edit. Then you can choose the fields that you want to include on the idea submission form. Let's add a field here to capture the urgency of the request. And then save the layout. Next, let's define idea categories to group ideas. This helps your community find ideas related to their needs, and it also makes it easier for you to review requests. So let's add a new one for social. Back in settings, you can also tailor the statuses that you use and the ones that show up in your portal to convey how ideas are progressing through your process. A handy tip is that down here, you can also add a template to the description field on your idea form to standardize how people submit feedback. As you can see from all of these other tabs, there are so many other things that you can customize, including the emails you send to customers to keep them informed of the status of their ideas, the terminology that you use in your portal, and how you manage who can access your portal. Okay, I think we're ready to start using our portal. So let's go back to the Overview tab and scroll down to the bottom to make sure that it's enabled. A handy tip here is that you can toggle between your settings and your published portal to make sure that everything looks good before you share the link. You'll want to link your portal from your app, your knowledge base, and anywhere else your customers go for support, so they know exactly where to share their feedback. Then get ready to start seeing ideas come in. Review and prioritize them right here in the Ideas Overview. If you need help, you can use the question mark icon in your account. Our customer success team is all former product managers with deep experience centralizing and managing customer feedback. We're here to help you be the expert on what your customers need so you can build lovable products. Thank you.